Guys, welcome to InspireUI channel on YouTube. In this video, I will show you how to install the FluxStore Shopify app on Windows through 5 simple steps. Please note that the app mainly supports Shopify Store. If you want to know more about our FluxStore Shopify app, please visit our store and you can refer to our FluxStore apps as well. I will put the link in the description under this video. Okay, now let's start. Step 1. Install the GraphiQL. It would be easy for you to search GraphiQL on Google. You need to choose this link and go to GraphiQL page. Here, you will see the downloading file for Windows, and please click the file to install. For Mac OS or Linux, please follow this guide in the GraphiQL page, or you can learn more in our tutorial video about FluxStore Shopify app installation on Mac. And yes, you need to open the file to complete installation. After installing the GraphiQL system for me, we will move on to get the Storefront SS key of Shopify admin website. Now, I will navigate to the page shopify.dev. All the information we need is in the documents of the website. Please find the Getting Started page of Storefront API to get the command performed here, X Shopify Storefront SS token. Then go to your Shopify admin website. On the left hand side, click apps and then manage private apps here. And continue to choose create new private app. In this page, please input your app name and emergency developer email. Now click here to show inactive admin API permissions. You will see a lot of inactive permissions here, and they need changing the option into read access or read and write. Now you need to allow this app to access your Storefront data using the Storefront API. Please click all of these options and save it. Now you get a notification that private app created successfully. Scroll down to the bottom. You can see your storefront SS key here. You need to do this step in GraphiQL. Choose Edit HTTP headers. Okay, in this position, sometimes you may see some old values available here. Just remove them by clicking Delete. Otherwise, please directly click on Add Header. You can see we have two blank boxes to fill in our header name and header value. Have you remembered in step 2, we opened the page Shopify.dev? Yes, we will get the header name there. Copy the command in the page Shopify.dev. And paste to GraphiQL. And the same, copy the storefront SS key that you got in step 2 and paste to GraphiQL. And then save it. Now is the time for Android Studio. First, please open your source code in Android Studio. And find the file config.dart in libcommon. Look at the code in the right hand side. What you need to do is fill in your website URL and storefront SS key in the code. Then return to the GraphiQL. And I will type my website URL here. And then add API GraphiQL. After that, delete all of this. And type the new command to get the ID. In the right hand side, click DOS to see the root types and choose query root. Now just follow what I do on the screen. Do not forget the curly braces for each command. Finally, click this button to run. Now, copy the generated ID and paste to your config file. If you are wondering where is the config file, so just follow me again. Now you will paste your ID here in the category. Lastly, try and run your Shopify app on the emulator. Click Run. Okay, it ran successfully. As you can see here, this is how my Shopify app will perform on the mobile phone. Now, to check out the shopping cart, you need to add some payment gateways, which I will show you in the last step, Configure Payment Gateway. To do this step, you will go to your Shopify admin website, click Settings, and choose Payments. Please make sure that you adjust and check all of these options. It's the end of the video. I hope you like it. Subscribe and leave your comments for us to make more useful tutorial videos. Thank you for your watching. Goodbye.